I see. So Marquess Rogner will be absent as well. I take it this means House Higharms will be the only one of the four great houses in attendance.
Would that it were different. For all of his faults, Marquess Rogner is a man of principle. Which makes his continuing house arrest for his actions during the Civil War all the more unfortunate.
One can't be too careful with a man who can lead his own militia. Though compared to the Governor General of Crossbell, he's a mere child playing with toys.
Useless.
Sorry, just idle thoughts. By the by, what kind of man is this Marquess Ballard?
Every bit the man the rumors make him out to be. Foolhardy and greedy, but dangerously savvy when it comes to matters of personal gain. I can't even imagine how his presence will disrupt our conference, and I'm unfortunate enough to be his caretaker.
Well, with your father there, I can't imagine he'll be too much of a terror. Marquess Higharms tends to have a sobering effect on people.
Very true. My father does not suffer fools gladly. But after the recent incidents in Crossbell and Sutherland, there's no telling what to expect. You would do well to exercise caution yourself.
You hardly need to remind me. Besides, I'm going to be among people I trust.
That's right. I suppose the conference does overlap with the branch campus's field exercises. Something else for me to look forward to. It will be a pleasure to see Class One's former rivals reunited after all.
Lord Eustace, your visitor has arrived.
Yes, let her in.
Right this way, young lady.
Thanks!
How's it going, Eustace? Long time no see!
Hello, Milliam. You're a little late.
It's not my fault it takes so long to get approved. Why do I need to get permission every time I want to see you anyway?
The reason should be obvious, given each of our positions.
Yeah! Hey! Dodging's no fair!
Sometimes I fear you'll never learn. You're 15 now, aren't you? Would it kill you to act a bit more ladylike?
Lammy!
Oh, hell.
Gotcha.
Get off me. You can't just jump on someone in an outfit like that.
Oh, you want to compare fashion notes, Mr. Fancy Haircut? But fine, if it keeps you from getting any more wrinkles.
Just get off.
Now this is good! Every bit as tasty as the pancakes Tilly and I had earlier.
You know, the children in town are starting to act more like you. Why do I get the feeling you've been teaching them?
Well, we have been hanging out a little. Every time I come visit you, I get to know them a little better. They're all really good kids.
So what if she was artificially created? She's just like any other girl. Aside from her complaints about not getting taller anyway.
Something on your mind?
Not at all. So, how are things on your end? As for me, my schedule remains unchanged.
All right. Even with all the crazy stuff that's happened, I should be good to go. Are you excited? You and me going on vacation.
I suppose the place is so pretty that it would feel like a vacation. Even if we're walking into what is essentially a carnival of villainy.
You've got a way with words, Eusis. I just wish I had access to more information. Even if most of the classified stuff is just about nobles and the Bracer Guild.
I wouldn't worry about it. That's standard operating procedure for the Intelligence Division. Though, I imagine your status as an Ironblood gets you more leeway than others.
Still, if I had the same clearance as Lecter, I could be so much more helpful to everyone from Class 7. Reen, Halisa, and Machias seem to have it especially tough. V and Sarah, though, I think they can take care of themselves.
You don't have to worry about taking care of any of us. Besides, the fact that you're a part of Class 7 means so much more to us than any political favor you could offer.
I'm giving you another hug.
No, you are not.
Wait, what's that sound?
It must be Class 7 related. I wonder what happened.
No way!
Could it be?
Been a while, Eusis. Huh? Oh, and Milliam is with you too.
Gaius!
They're really going at it. I figured Needhog would be good, but the other guys are no slouches themselves. Betcha they'll give us a pretty good fight.
They've both been in shambles ever since the Civil War. The dragon lost its head. And as for the other group, well...
Guess this makes it a fight neither side can afford to lose. I'd like to have a battle with a certain someone myself.
You wouldn't be talking about little old me now, would you? Easy now, Blitz. I'm unarmed, see? I should be the one on edge here.
Sorry, but I'd rather not take any chances. Not with someone who can go toe-to-toe with Lord Balder.
Aw, lighten up! Can't you relax around an old drinking buddy?
I think Daddy might be the only person who could drink with you and not be nervous. That said, this is pretty weird. I saw you and Uncle Balder kill each other with my own eyes. And now you're here. Does this have something to do with that cool purple shadow thing?
Who can say? Seriously, though, you don't really want to start a fight in a place like this, do you? The two of you against little old me? I'd have zero chance of winning.
You're real funny, old man. But I get it. We're all just observers this time. So, once you get things squared away with your business, come pay us a visit. We'll be waiting.
Excuse us, Jaeger King.
really had me sweating there. Old man like me wouldn't stand a chance against all that youthful exuberance. Don't you think? I'm just talking to myself. Don't let it spook you. The Colonel, your dad, took good care of me back in the day. Introduced me to my favorite brand of smokes. By the way, I meant to thank you for taking care of Fee. Chasing us from battlefield to battlefield's all well and good, but raising that kid right is what really matters, even if you're practically a kid yourself.
Yikes. That was just like 3 years ago.
Colonel. I haven't heard that in a while.
Bloody Shirley. No, the Sanguine Ogre. She had to have noticed me too. I've been off the front lines for too long. Meanwhile, Fee's been picking up skill after skill. I'm really starting to feel my age.
Wait, what am I saying? I'm only 27. Well, almost 28, but either way, I'm too young to be old. Okay, Sarah, focus. We've got two of the strongest Jaeger corps, the dragons and these Jaegers in purple, battling it out.
One way or another, things are gonna come to a head. For me and for the kids.
And you know, even if he is a far cry from the Viscount, I have to admit, the Jaeger King is a real fox.
Well, someone's early for a change. Basking in its glory? Even I was surprised when I first saw it.
Yeah. I hear there's another one in a place called Nord.
Yes. Just about the same size, too. Even though it's a very different shape. Wait, is something bothering you?
No. I don't sense any power within this thing. It's nothing but a shell. Just makes me wonder where the insides went.
Insides?
Sorry we're late.
Have you been a good girl, Dubali? Took you too long enough.
I said sorry. Oh, the almighty conflagration is with you.
My, are we interrupting something intimate?
Don't even joke about that. I would never. Especially not with some lazy, irresponsible bum like him.
Never is right. No man could ever sway a little lord's pet like her. Well, aside from maybe that Ashen kid, isn't he your type?
Oh.
Dear me.
Absolutely not! And what do you mean, lord's pet? If anything, Mick Byrne, you don't have enough respect for the Anguis.
I guess that makes two of us.
It's you.
It has been a while, fool.
When was the last time? The crossbell incident?
I believe so. Though we've all been busy roaming across the continent, so I won't hold it against you. With that, all of us who were stationed to the west are here. Except Shirley, that is.
Yeah, the crazy ogre chick's off getting a read on the front lines.
The thought of her off on her own scares me a little. But we have preparations to make before our beautiful and proud lord arrives.
There's no need for that.
My lord.
I didn't expect you to arrive so early. My lord! I'm so glad you're here. I didn't think I would get to see you so soon.
Nor did I. I thought we had several days left to wait.
Did something change among the Anguis?
Yes. The Oathbreaker and Lady Mariabelle decided to take on Artaria. And the Professor completed the final Ion earlier than planned.
Sounds like he's been working hard.
He probably didn't like what happened to his last one.
Ah, Campanella and McBurn. How long has it been? About a year?
Sounds about right.
Still wearing that clunky helmet of yours, I see. There's a nice breeze right now, so why don't you take it off?
McBurn! How dare you say that to our lord?
Now, Duvalie. He's no subject of mine. Since we're ahead of schedule, why don't we have a little duel? If you can manage to tear this helm from my head, I'll be able to feel the lovely breeze you mentioned.
Nah, I'm good. Not because I think I'll lose, but because I don't think I can actually win. Just like all of our other fights.
What?
You're right. Although, the outcomes may have been different had you taken my sword lessons more seriously.
Damn it, don't treat me like I'm Louvre.
Just what is their relationship?
Now, let us begin. The third of our experiments to reclaim the Phantasmal Blaze plan. To determine whether or not a vessel can gain power through combat.
I'll go first. I'm Musei Egret. I've transferred from military finance to join you here in Class 7. It's truly a pleasure to meet you all.
Ash Carbide, transferring from combat tactics. Got no plans to make friends here. But nice to meet you, I guess.
Thank you. Stand. Bow.
Thank you.
Yes! Thanks.
Yes! Thanks!
Thank you.
help?
Thank you.
Thanks. I'll help. Thanks. Yes! Thanks. Yes. Thanks. 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 Yes. Thanks. Yes. Thanks. I'll help. Thanks. Yes! Thanks.
Yes! Thanks! I'll help! Thanks. Let me know what you need. Stay safe.
Thank you. got this in the bag. Mm-hmm.
Huh, what a pain. Just eat it already.
Initiate cooking mode.
Thank you.
All right, there. Catch you later. All right, there. To see you again. Thank you.
Now, bring it on!
Good job.
Gotcha!
That was good.
Thanks, instructor.
For the honor of Schleiden. Thank you.
Give us a shout and I'll get you what you need.
Catch you later.
Got some good stuff. Done already? I got some good stuff. Done already. I got some good stuff. Done already?
Let's begin. That's unfortunate.
This might be a good spot for fishing. There. Got a bite. Nice. Not bad at all. There. Got a bite. This is promising. Not bad at all. There. Got a bite. Nice. It's a whopper! There! Got a bite! Nice! It's a whopper! There. Got a bite. Nice.
Well, it's not bad.
There. Got a bite. This is promising. It's a whopper. There. Got a bite. This is promising.
Got it!
There!
Got a bite!
Nice!
I got it!
There!
Got a bite.
This is promising.
I got it.
There.
Got a bite.
This is promising.
Got it!
There!
Got a bite! This is promising. I got it! There. Got a bite. This is promising. Well, it's not bad. There. Got a bite. This is promising. Got it! There! Got a bite! Nice! It's a whopper! There! Got a bite. It got away. There. Got a bite. Nice. I got it. There. Got a bite. This is promising. It's a whopper.
Got this in the bag.
It turned out great.
Got this in the bag.
It turned out great. Have a taste.
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out...
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out great.
I got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned...
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out...
I got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out...
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out...
Let's do this.
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out...
I got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out great!
I got this in the bag!
Mm-hmm. It turned out...
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out great.
I got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out...
I got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It's perfect. It turned out great.
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out...
got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out...
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out.
I got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out.
I got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out.
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out.
I got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out.
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out.
I got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out.
Got this in the bag.
Mm-hmm. It turned out great.
Thank you.
see you're on your way back, too.
Hey there, Toa, Celine. You two together is quite the rare sight.
I suppose it is, now that you mention it.
I guess so. It took quite some effort on her part to convince everyone to let a talking cat stay here.
I see. Thank you for taking the time to do all that.
It didn't take any time. Just had to do a few quick chats with people at the campus and in town. Just make sure you don't let any visitors catch you talking, okay, Celine?
Yeah, I know that. I've been hiding myself with Emma for years now. I wouldn't make such an amateurish.
Holy crap, a talking cat!
Meow! Wait a second. I know you weren't expecting me, Reen. Good day to you, Toa.
Elise! And is that?
Sorry about that. Looks like I got you good.
George!
Long time no see, Toa. And how's it hanging, Reen? Celine? I happened to run into your sister on the train from Heimdall.
Thank you.
Looks like you've kept this place clean. Though the building itself may be old, everything inside is well organized. Yes, I can tell. However, the hard-to-reach spots could use some attention. Oh, I know. Don't worry, I'll give your room a thorough cleaning tomorrow. There should be no problems, provided I get back by evening. Knowing you, you'll be working even on your off days, am I right? I don't intend to get in the way of you helping out your school or your students. I came to visit and volunteered to help out of my own free will, so please go about your business as usual. I accept your conditions. Oh, and Rin, here are the letters from Father and Master Yoon. Those letters weren't sent to me through the post office, but a shipping company. Perhaps he did it for your sake. Rin? Did something happen between you and Father? When you came home at the end of last year, there seemed to be something off between the two of you. I can't imagine what it might be, but did something happen at the end of the Civil War? And could that something have led to a rift between you and Father?
I'm glad to finally see you again, my son. You've grown into a fine young man. Indeed, the Empire will soon know of the Ashen Chevalier, the hero whose brave deeds allowed us to reclaim the capital.
Right.
Excuse us?
Everyone.
We just finished getting the bed all set up.
I went and brought back some extra pajamas, too.
Oh. Told you he sends us.
Oh, don't act like you weren't just as curious as the rest of us, Altina. The Schwarzer siblings alone together. A forbidden delight sweeter than the finest confection.
Musée!
Ah, that's it! It's been so long since you've scolded me like that, Elise!
You're all making way too much racket. Don't go around shouting in the halls. I'm trying to take a catnap here and... Ow! What do you think you're doing?
You should join us, Celine. There are so many things I need to ask you.
Good thinking. I'm sure Celine has plenty of juicy details about our instructor's school days.
Juicy details? Oh, we're gonna have so much fun tonight.
Well, on that note, good night, Rin.
Thank you.
I want you to take in a child. You must cut all ties with me and never speak a word of this to that child. I'm sorry, Teo. You're the only one I can turn to.
Here are today's requests.
Thank you. It's simply the result of my tireless pursuit of profit on behalf of the company. Hey there, Reen. Haven't seen you since graduation. And it's been even longer than that for us, Machias. Who would have thought I'd run into you two on a sales trip? Maybe us Thor's alums are just drawn to each other.
Things are tough for both of us, but let's each give it our all. I know each of you are working your hardest in your own ways. That's why I can't afford to give up.
I am Ada of the main campus's Class 1.
I'm Fritz, also from Class 1. A pleasure, Instructor Schwarzer.
Thank you. Now,